Russian aggression in Ukraine has made Europe aware of the danger from the Kremlin. Most European countries have come together to oppose Vladimir Putin and his hegemonic ambitions. Serbia is the only country that has not clearly defined its position towards Russia. In addition to the hypocritical policies of the Serbian government, which, on the one hand, claims to be European, and on the other hand continues with a fraternal alliance with Putin, in Serbia there are other factors that make the Serbian position more unclear. Representatives of the far right of some European countries have held important positions in Belgrade for several years. These exponents of the European far right are mostly allied with Russia. They are special envoys in Belgrade, tasked with strengthening the pro-Russian element in Serbia.
Grad ima veliki potencijal. Grad jeste podeljen, to je poznato, ne samo u Bosni, ne samo na Balkanu, nego u celom svetu. Jeste podeljen.
In the first part of the short documentaries, the Geopost will present Arnaud Guyon, from the extreme right of France, who is positioned high in Serbian diplomacy.
Onog dana kada sam u Francuskoj osnovao humanitarnu organizaciju Solidarnost za Kosovo, neko rekao, kroz 10 godina živet ćeš u Beogradu, govorit ćeš srpski, žena će ti biti Srpkinja. Dobit ćeš i pasoš Republike Srbije i to od ruke ministra unutrašnjih poslova. Ne bih mu ni u snu poverovao.
In addition to receiving the Serbian passport, the government of Serbia, on November 26, 2020, appointed Arnaud Guyon as head of an important directorate of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. He, on behalf of the government of Serbia, will lead the Directorate for Cooperation with the Diaspora and Serbs in the region. But, let's see who Arnaud Guyon really is. The Identitarians is an identitarian nationalist movement in France. Like the French New Right, scholars generally consider the movement far-right or sometimes as a syncretic mixture of multiple ideologies across the political spectrum. The group additionally advocates an anti-American and anti-Islamic foreign policy, calling the United States and Islam the two major imperialistic threats to Europe. Arnaud Guyon joined Identitaires in 2003, almost as soon as the structure appeared. This organization was born after the dissolution of the nationalist revolutionary group, Unité Radicale, after one of its supporters tried to assassinate French President Chirac on July 14, 2002. Officially, Arnaud Guyon joined the group in 2007 as a spokesperson.
Parce que mes ancêtres ont poussé la Reconquista jusqu'à Grenade et ont libéré l'Espagne du joug musulman. Je suis un Européen parce que mes ancêtres étaient aux côtés de Charles Martel en 732.
Ce jacobinisme centralisateur a successivement cherché à diaboliser, culpabiliser et à ringardiser les appartenances locales. La métropole incarnant exclusivement la région, Paris devenant exclusivement la France et la voix de la France, et Washington, sorte de nouvel mec du monde libre. Nous pensons que tout cela est autant d'excès et de déséquilibre.
He is the founder of the association Solidarité Kosova, whose roots are deeply rooted in a pan-European nationalist political ideology of the extreme right. Although he distributed aid to Serb enclaves in Kosovo, the organization he founded in 2005, Solidarite Kosovo, served Guyon, more like a Trojan horse, to penetrate public spaces not only in France but also in other European Union countries. In 2008, Arnaud Guyon visited the European Parliament, where he lobbied for Serbian interests towards Kosovo, on the eve of the start of the ULEX mission. In a statement to the media, he said that "we will explain to them a different view of the situation in Kosovo, unlike the Albanian lobbyists and the Western media." At the same time, Guyon continued the activities of the far-right representative in France, protesting and inciting violence against immigrants.
Ainsi lancé en grande pompe Génération Identitaire, la nouvelle branche jeunesse de cette formation d'extrême droite radicale, dont l'un des dirigeants s'appelle Philippe Vardon, 29 ans et leader d'un groupe de rock. À deux semaines de leur convention qui se tiendra à Orange, la ville de l'ex-Front National Jacques Bompard, Bloc Identitaire fêtera ses 10 ans d'existence.
Ils veulent montrer un visage plus fréquentable. Leur service d'ordre fait barrage aux éléments les plus virulents. Le représentant des identitaires se démarque des fauteurs de troubles.
C'est l'intérêt d'avoir un groupe organisé comme le Bloc Identitaire, c'est qu'on peut faire face à toutes les situations, face à des risques qui peuvent être externes, comme les menaces de la part d'extrémistes de gauche, ou des risques qui pourraient être plus internes par rapport à des personnes qui auraient un mauvais comportement.
These violent demonstrations were in France. And the pictures you are seeing now are in the Western Balkans. Here, Arnaud Guyon has now joined Serbian extremists in a march aimed at inciting conflict between Serbia and Kosovo. With a little care, you will clearly notice his infiltration along with members of the Russian terrorist organization, called the Russian Imperialist Movement. This Russian terrorist organization is the umbrella of most far-right European organizations. Their most radical representatives are already among the Russian aggressor forces in Ukraine. They are also closely associated with the extremist clergy of the Orthodox Church. Arnaud Guyon converted to the Serbian Orthodox Church in 2015, when he received his Serbian passport. To perform the rite of baptism, he chose the monastery of Dečin, which is located in the Republic of Kosovo. Serbian nationalism has consistently misused the church in order to have the highest possible impact. Common to the European far-right and Serbo-Russian orthodoxy is the struggle against Western values, anti-Americanism and illiberalism. Following these policies, Arnaud Guyon has chosen to look as Serbian as possible. To cheat, because his conversion to orthodoxy convinces the Serbs more in his mission of incitement, disunity. Also, Arnaud Guyon as an orthodox will influence Serbs more, that makes him exactly an influencer. So, Guyon's goal is not to allow Serbia to move closer to Western democratic values, i.e. to keep it as far away from liberalism and Western security policies, NATO. With clear tendencies to hinder the democratization of Serbia, and to keep it as close as possible to the policies of the far right, Arnaud Guyon has actively participated in anti-Western demonstrations.
Extremisti su ljudi koji žele da prodaju Kosovo i Metohija za tri pare. Zajedno sa zemljama koje su bombardovali pre 10 godina Srbiju, ekstremisti su ljudi koji ne obrane Kosovo i Metohija, koje misle samo na pare, koje misle samo za stomaka. Dakle, ja sam iz Francuske, znam da Možná naše političani jsou uvek radili dobrý izbory. Ale samozřejmě znáte, naše političani nejsou pýtali můj národ. Šta myslí o Kosovu? Nejsou pýtali, dali želimo da bombardovali naše bratě z historie. Naše bratě.
In modern language, someone who actually introduces someone else is called a proxy. Arnaud Guyon is exactly a typical Putin proxy, first in France, and then in Serbia. He has even sometimes surpassed the level of proxy because he has made direct calls for ties with Russia. In 2011, Arnaud Guyon, it is clear that he collaborated with the Serbian far-right organization, called Movement 1389, known for its proximity to Russia. Guyon's Russian collaborators, the organization, Nashi's true function was as a personality cult for Putin whose job was intimidate, bully and harass his opponents.
Les France, le rejet de l'islam et des musulmans peut-il être le fondement d'un programme politique et susciter l'adhésion des citoyens électeurs? Éléments de réponse avec nos invités. À vos côtés, Arnaud
Guyon was the candidate for president of France from Bloc Identitaire in the 2012 elections. His campaign, as a white supremacist, relied primarily against Africans. However, he denied these and many of his radical attitudes in a TV show in Serbia.
Što se tiče pokreta koji ste spomenuli, on više, čini mi se, ne postoji. On je postojao u Francuskoj nekoliko godina, okupio oko sebe nekoliko stotina članova. I što se tiče njihovih...
Bili ste član?
Ja sam bio član 6 meseci, od 2010. do 2011.
The truth is that Arnaud Guyon was officially part of the French Identities from September 12, 2007 until 2012, when before the presidential election, for financial reasons, he withdrew from the election.
Srbija angažovan, onda valjda i u Francuskoj očekivano i da sam angažovan oko nekih stvari.
During these years, Arnaud Guyon, in addition to being one of the leading ideological figures of the generation of extreme French identity, he also led their own paramilitary camps. As trainer in these camps, Arnaud Guyon taught young people how to physically deal with their political and ideological opponents. This camp, set up in Lyon, France from 17 to the 22nd of August 2008, bore the racist name Revolts Against the Modern World. Another element that Arnaud Guyon has, which belongs to the characteristics of Russian activity, is propaganda and misinformation. Senior Serbian diplomacy officer, the representative of the French far right, Arnaud Guyon has also been involved in the production of documentaries. His narrative is exactly the same as the narrative of the Russian state-controlled media. With this misinformation activity, he continues to incite hatred between the peoples in the Western Balkans. In fact, Arnaud Guyon, this was his mission in France with the extreme right. While in France it was against Americans and people of color, in the Western Balkans it was against Albanians, Bosniaks, Montenegrins and Croats.
Objavio si na nekoliko jezika. Koliko je to bitno?
To je bitno zato što prvo sam objavio na srpskom, pošto kao što sam rekao, i sami Srbi u centralnoj Srbiji nisu svesni svega što se dešava na Kosovu i Metohiji. I oni kao Srbi moraju prvo da budu obavešteni o tome i da reaguju.
Arno Guion has a lot of space in the most popular media in Russia. As you can see, he is talking in Putin's media, Sputnik, about how even the Serbs themselves are not aware of how endangered they are in Kosovo.
Onda sam objavio na francuskom jeziku, objavili smo i članak na našem sajtu i poslali saopštenje. Objavio sam i na engleskom i na ruskom jeziku, zato što Srbi nisu sami u svetu. Možda nema, osim možda i Rusije i Kine, nekih, u svakom slučaju, zapadnih država koji javno podržavaju srpsku stvar, ali ima prijatelja Srbije i na zapadu, koji govore i francuski, koji govore i engleski. I njima sam želeo također da se obratim. I to je ono što radimo do duše sa našom humanitarnom organizacijom već 15 godina.
In this interview, Arno Guion admits that what he has been doing with his so-called humanitarian organization for 15 years is the information war. Let's see it one more time.
I to je ono što radimo do duše sa našom humanitarnom organizacijom već 15 godina.
Arno Guion's information war is often with Serbs who do not have the same views as the government in Serbia and who have true Western orientations.
Veliki pozdrav svima iz Moskve, iza mene, kao što možete da vidite, je Kremlj, zaista predivan.
In conclusion, this documentary, made with desktop researchers, analyzing Arno Guion, it can be seen that the Frenchman with a Serbian passport mostly acts in strategic interests for the policies of the official Kremlin.